I now request everyone to stand up for the national anthem.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharata Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchchala Jaladhi Taranga तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे
Technology and innovation have always been an important factor in deciding a nation's success. And as Dr. Kiran Kumar said in his EML lecture, unless we keep learning and developing new technology, we may very soon find ourselves obsolete. Thus, it is important for us to recognize the contribution by the many organizations and the people running it. Today, we have the honor of hosting Dr. Y.S. Rajan, who's one of the most prominent scientists in the country. He made major contributions to various aspects of science, technology, and innovation. He was awarded Padma Shri for his contribution in science and engineering in 2012. He held several positions in ISRO and is now an honorary distinguished professor there. He was elected a member of the International Academy of Astronautics way back in 1986. He was the first executive director of TIFAC, Technology Information and Forecasting and Assessment Council, and executed Mission REACH, an initiative of it. He has held several senior positions in National Natural Resource Management System, part of CII, Confederation of Indian Industry. He has closely worked with Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam and co-authored the popular book, India 2020, A Vision for the New Millennium. He has authored many such books, such as Discover Your Power Quotient and Discover Your Power Quotient, and has written over 200 articles and papers which have been published in international journals. I would now like to request Professor Subhash Sridharam to welcome chief guest with a fruit basket. May I now request our distinguished speaker for the evening to deliver his much anticipated talk on technology and innovation, Where is India?
First of all, thank you very much for this opportunity. This is a very prestigious institution. I had come here the first, I think it was with Professor, yes, Dhawan, Satish Dhawan. I don't know whether many of you will know who it is. I am not going to expand on that. Then Professor Pandale was there, the director. I was very young, lot of interesting experiences. From that I have come several times, including for the Knowledge Forum, with Dhawan, etc. Now I just, because this is a multidisciplinary group, I just want to quickly see who are all the engineering side. Just wanted to get a see. You are humanities, which broadly includes economics and all that. Okay, it was only a interest versing of them. So it is predominantly technology people. Okay. So how many are there? Just the post two, that is, and what you call it as undergraduate, no? Graduate or undergraduate, whatever, B-Techs. B-Techs are less. That means those who are doing B-Tech. I thought there is a large number. Okay, fine, good. That means you all pass that and you are around postgraduate in technology or PhD, etc., etc. Okay, because that will put the this one. See, this is a subset. See, the life never is one. You have to go to the real action takes place in the 7th or 8th level of disaggregation, engineering, then if I have to say which engineering, if I have to talk to bioengineering, it is something. So that I did not. If I disaggregate it, I will have a lot of problem. I am not going to address that. That's the reason. So I know now, bulk of you have passed through a phase of B.Tech, etc., then into several others, some who are in the beginning phases of it. Okay, that's all I wanted to understand. Pure sciences, I put everything together. Physical sciences and its applied forms. Okay, correct? Now I have aggregated one level higher. How many pure sciences? He wants to know. How many pure sciences? I think you are the only one. Okay, within that then I will ask further. Maths, because it doesn't belong to any of them. How many are maths? None. Okay, doesn't matter. Pure maths. That is pure, not pure maths, applied maths, all forms of maths. Okay, just I got an idea. Then, do you have anything specifically you want me to address? Well, I am going to talk about the processes of innovation, because there are a lot of things good that you raised about science. I am going to say, what is science? What is engineering? There is quite a bit of difference. They are twins or whatever you want to call it, DNA, RNA, whatever you want to call it, they are twins, but they are not same. And engineering is not an automatic output of science. Sometimes engineering helps science to go up. I can give you several examples. Without engineering, certain forms of science would not have come at all. Then the other way around, some of the engineering, tough engineering problem later gets solved by some knowledge of science. Because you get into some problem, then you say why it is happening. So there is an intertwining, but they are not same. This, even not realized, cannot give products. Number two, engineering is not just something which you do and publish paper or publish patent. Engineering predominantly will mean to produce products and services, which is of society, therefore economy comes, this one comes, etc. It's a very complex process of what you give in the product. So this is a process which I want to tell you. Then the whole question of industry which is there, which is use of engineering, is not pure economics alone. There's a lot of business works which are there. That takes place partly within engineering itself. Developing an engineering product is a part of business management. Technology management and all are that. See, for example, persons like Dr. Kalam, his excellence come in that. He's not a, to me also they say, scientist, TK, every time one can't be, I did of course my postgraduate in physics, but I am not a scientist in that sense of the term of basic research, my publication will be different. Because it turned that way, otherwise I started to know the purest form of science, cosmic rays. What is happening there, the solar, when the solar is going up, I am so happy. Because the Eugene Parker, and it is full of mathematics. Full of mathematics. In those days when numerical, that is around 60s, he did it, I was gotten into 64, where it was full of, many of them will be transcendental equations. Now, numerical model, computers itself in those days was 1620 or something, IBM 1620, we'll have to be doing Fortran. You can't do anything. But this gentleman used physical intuition, put it to the maths, so many factors will be, okay, this is negligible, that is negligible, and then that is how he predicted solar wind. It is one of those experiments in which Professor U.R. Rao was involved, not from India, from U.S. Solar wind was first detected in Mariner satellite, small gigahertz. Now, he's going to go there. So the old man said very beautifully, he's around 91, very rare will be a person who does such thing purely on maths. He was in University of Chicago, I think, Eugene Parker. So he says, oh God, I'm just seeing, you can see hundreds of animations or pictures of Taj Mahal, but to see Taj Mahal by itself, that's what is going to take place for him. In his lifetime, he will see all those things, plasma, the frozen field, the magnetic field, all those predictions are going to take place. We are going to see it. But he did science with a large use of scientific intuition with maths. That gave, but it is possible to see it with engineering things. That prod which has gone on. Our newspapers flash, and many of you may not take interest in it. It would have been a 25-year-old project. One of the young person who told me that before you were born, those fellows would have started working on it. What a type of materials. Corona, bombardment of temperature. Anyway, now it is that. So unless you have very specific things, I will go through some type of realities of India, which is not often talked about. Many of you may not have thought about it. Some of you may have, much more better than me also. What happens is we always say, India is one market. 1 billion, 1.2 billion. Partly true. When you start disaggregating, that's the reason I told about the disaggregation. Part you disaggregate, not all of them can be given the same engineering product. So not possible. Or same, when I use the word engineering, take it also the medical practice. That is, those who deliver actual medical practice comes under that. You can't give the same. You can't give the same type of people talk about it, I want this drug and that drug. It is not possible. That is where economics comes in. You can't just, you have to make the ends to meet. So how it is important to understand, because an engineer has to, or a service deliverer, his product or services or his innovation has to be adapted to the market. If it is not adapted to the market, it will not sell. If it doesn't sell, it dies. There are many innovations which go through the valley of death, partly through technological problem, greatly due to non-understanding of markets. So I'm trying to give you that glimpse. Then there are processes in India, we have certain very peculiar problem. See, we have got the best brains, we'll say, yes, right. Because many of the best brains somehow seem to be getting roots or flower not within this country. It's a very, very sorrow fact, because when I was young, we were thinking that the Tamil Subramanya Bharati and all that we will do. But it is not as simple. You look at it, because at some point of time, you have to look at the mirror. They do it there. Reasons are very many, because part of it is because our systems got formed without understanding it. So we have to need time to understand what it is and then go accordingly. Now, what to do with the backlog? Simply saying leapfrog is not possible, because I learned quite a bit of my early part of technology development almost. I joined Vikram Sarabhai. That was all in Cosmic Rays. Then I told him, it is not possible for you to do here, because the technological and other growths with NASA and all were doing, you can't do it because you have to have satellites. So we didn't have the technological wherewithal, let alone money. So he told me, get into engineering, into ISRO. That is what I am. So then went to NASA, MIT and all that thing for study. And coming to Dhawan, he used to tell on the leapfrogging. Rajan, see, everybody can talk. Sarabhai also used the word leapfrogging. But when you see ISRO's development, it was not a leapfrog. He says, engineering, mind you, I don't know how many of you know about Satish Dhawan a little bit. Okay, some small number, it is very bad. Because he, without him, the program would not have been there. Because those of you, he was a self-effacing man. He is an engineer par excellence. He was an academic par excellence. He has done under Von Karman. He's not a very ordinary, he has done in this one. In addition, he was also good in English. He was a postgraduate in English by himself. I don't know why he did it, but that's another, but he was par excellence. So he will say, Rajan, I had an opportunity to work with him for the whole of his room, many things. So he used to, Rajan, this leapfrogging, people talk. We can only think and then say, I leapfrog. Engineering is an assiduous process, brick by brick. You remember this. You look at whether it is Japan following the Americans, or earlier, the Industrial Revolution took place in UK. Machines were done there. It is the Germans who followed it up. They almost copycatted the machines and other things. There is a Stein-Bass Foundation, variety of them. One economist who got them to do that. Then they started innovating on chemical engineering. So you have bar subversive, etc. Then later they of course mastered that also. You look at Japan, look at Korea later. See our northern neighbor. Engineering, anything which starts, you want to get in into an excellence in that level. Individual, I'm not talking about there will be exceedingly very good individual thinker. But for a country as a whole to be done, it takes around 20 years. Samsung, you look at anybody. What I am telling is, I have studied a lot of research work. Samsung, 1970, LG, Samsung, and all, nothing. In fact, we had a national echo. I got the big box of radio. We were far ahead in electronics than Koreans were. And when they started shipbuilding, all American economists and everybody, what the hell, you fellows don't have material, don't this thing. So they got into it, but it was an assiduous process. Same thing with Japan, same thing Israel. So this, I want to be essentially, I will do that. But now, how to compress, having told 20 years, we have wasted so many 20 years. So how to do that, there are some processes which I will show. It is called technology intermediate. With that, I will leave. So since you are not told any specific topic, I think without this also you are able to hear. Are you able to hear without this? Makes it easy.
Better with that.
It is better with that? Okay. Because other one frees my hand. Because anyway, if that is so, then I will do that. Now, start it. No, it is not that. The other one. First, it will start with the pyramid, no? Go back, back, back. See, we have to understand the Indian society. I think I don't have to show the... You are able to see it now up to the last? So, this is something I should say. We were doing it well, but I learned something from Sam Patroda. Used that aspect ratio. Because otherwise, we generally tend to crowd with too much of data, which is very important, but assume it as Q. So this is, don't take it the exact numbers. Don't try to find out which is the reference, etc. About 100 million Indians will be rich and super rich. My economic friends, don't ask for how many dollars. It is not on the dollars. It is the way they live. Because you have a rupee in Bihar, a rupee in Tamil Nadu, rupee in Punjab are different. I learned it by my long work. It's very different. So they can live a life, some of the best of the Europeans, best of Americans. They are needed because they are need to invest. If you take away the money and then distribute everybody, it will not last for 10 days. So there are only 10 million. It will become a little high. Many of you here will also have an aspiration. I become a startup and then I want to become that. It's good. But very few will go. That's the reality of life. Done not by me. There's a very good book, Eric something second part, The Wealth of Nations. Very few people get into this. Something, a Pareto equilibrium happens like that. Some very few people will be there all around the world. Anyway, that is being so. Upper middle class will be 200, 250. Many of you will belong there, at least in the bottom. When I started life, I was not there. I was in the second one. Now, after these things, some pension, accumulated money, etc., I am in the bottom of the upper middle class. But many young people who go and get, they will be, so many people are aspiring to become an upper middle class. Why I am saying this is 100 million fellows, they will not buy Indian product. They will not buy Indian service. They will go abroad. They will import their wine. They will import their cheese. Everything will be imported. So they are not a market for you. So if you want to do in India, but doesn't matter, one should not worry about it. That will work for the balance of payment. Oh, I bought from you, France, this much. So every country is worrying about balance of payment. You bought by it. This upper class, they want to be like them, but they can't afford. And they want services. And that is where a whole lot of money is there. You want to do a startup and other thing, it will be that. Whereas political people and also following that, many of our thought leaders also say, oh, yes, we want to do for rural India, we want to do for the best of the world. You can't do for rural India and that together. It won't be the same product. This is the thing which you should understand. Then the 200 million lower middle class, this may be changing. It may had a faster growth is there, economic growth is there, that will become more. If then the 700, the bulky base, that is what India is. This is not poor in the sense of what it was when we started off poverty. I have seen the poverty. We will all be very low. Fellows, now I don't see any, even a beggar child will not have a torn cloth. You can't use a torn cloth. Nobody will take it. That's a good progress for India. You can't give a old food. They won't take it, but that's good. But this poverty is that they are uncertain about the next day being. They are all, bulk of them are, they don't have a regular job, they will not have. The upper middle class also, many of them, they are the only fellows who are close to the organized sector jobs. They are only 6%. All the job creation people are talking around it. But bulk of these fellows are actually real day-to-day entrepreneurs. So now, this line, economic growth should be such that this line becomes somewhere here. Then you will create a lot of products. These people also, they are looking for a lot of products. Many of them, your maid servants, your peons, your drivers, all come under that. So you have to think in terms of products for this are different, products for this are different. Products for this, very different, and they may not always be economically remunerative for an entrepreneur in the beginning stages. That is where the public funding is necessary, some subsidy is necessary. But something remains on subsidy, it will die. That means it doesn't work. So this is what you have to understand. Now, next, now I'll fast forward. In India, what we do, if you look at it, oh, youth power, demographic dividend, Indian human capitals, variety of it on one side. Because you are all real human capital. But if you see in that tip, you are not even a nano tip. If I put that in terms of knowledge and other things which are there, which are capabilities, you are not even, I am showing the next one, you are a nano tip. Bulk of Indians, 70% of that bottom fellows, don't go past beyond fifth standard. Now with the RTE coming, they say eighth standard will pass kar diya. They push them. But nobody will take an eighth standard. When we were there in ISRO in those days, all the government wanted fourth standard pass will be an excellent thing for a driver. Because for him to pass that is tough. Now, it is 10 or 11 standard. Haryana police is 12 standard. Of course, they will say he has to know things, etc. But it's nice to know, say that. But people don't go up to 12th. What do you do? This is the reality of Indian job. Simply saying all the discussions are all meaningless. So I'll give some solution, but here that is a different. Other side of it is, oh, this too many colleges, everything all useless, everything mushrooming. Then the for we always like to see if foreign some fellow says, then we are very good. Even our own Nobel laureate was there, that Venkat. Nobody knew. No IIT system knew, no IIC knew, no INSA knew. That fellow gets a Nobel laureate. Then everybody wants to own him. He studied in Baroda. Somebody said in Trichinopoly, he studied in my school. Everybody wants him. So foreign pattern. Resultant is one point solution. We'll just say change. Make everything like IIT. All engineering. If all the 4,000 AICT affiliated colleges which is there, there'll be no takers. Because one thing about the market is, if there are too many, actually I didn't want this so many IITs. I was in the Knowledge Commission. I told Sam Patel, hey Baba, what is this? You are 10, 100, 100, etc. Don't tell. These 5 IITs with the 2 more was enough. The 2 more also was an aberration. Okay, Guwahati is okay. That is okay. That region required. Roorkee didn't have to be made in India. It is standing of its own. We pushed it. Now we are putting, hey, who wants to come? I will put IIT stamp on you. So then what will happen? Very simple. I told him, Anand Saab was there, he was chairing that thing. Sir, why are you doing? There is a law of Gresham's law. If you push a bad coin into the system, it will drive away all the good coins. And as you see it, what I'm saying is a lot of serious thoughts. Ivy League, There are only 7. So many years have passed. There are some exceedingly very good institutions, better than I believe. But have they put it inside? You want to be elitist, you have to be protected as elitist. But anyway, that's a different story. We do so many mix-up. So therefore, everybody, all make it into IIT. Where, who will give money? IITs are being given a lot of money. It has been poured. Without that, it won't come. So anyway, next. India, you want to imagine the demography, which I said 70%, is like this. Did it in 2005, where Sam Patoda was so happy, he told me to show to a US audience. This is like this. Approximately at each age group, so those of you 25, your cohorts, age cohorts will be 20. I won't get into the detail of it. It is like a next. It is like a India, fellows like me, we should have been long past dead had it been what continued in when I was born, whether it is Kalam or we all should have been gone off at the age 32, 50% of us should have gone. Our sisters, 26 age. Now we are there. We are likely to go up to 85. 85, you find many old people pass off now. But that is a point. But all of you young, please remember, you will go to 100. With fitted with titanium or I don't know, whatever it is, you will be there without any new technologies. So this one, so this bogey, you know how much? India is not just young alone, we are old also. That same 20 million per bogey means we are 5 bogeys, 60 plus. So actually adding every 5 million every year. So these bogeys are going and it is a steam engine. I put particularly because our economy is flowing chuck from that time onwards. It's very bad. It has to have a 10% growth. But anyway, next. So if now, this is the thing which I said, all the high professional studies, IIT, chartered accountant, anything which will come when you come out and then it will get a reasonable pay. MBBS, some very specific elite humanities, journalism, it will be only 1.5, you argue it may be 2%. Those who do 3 to 5 years after, this one will be called, now don't go by the GER. They will all say GER. GER is what, you know, gross enrollment ratio. They are very clever in this. Enrollment, how many continue through? See, they are all very particularly very correct enrollment ratio. So this is actually, this is like this. These are all the very beautifully Hindi expression for that will be, I hope some of you will understand Hindi, falana falana degree. It will be all that, history, this one in Tamil, that something, etc., all will be there. Then comes the 10 plus 2 and all, there is good statistics not available. They will never publish how many, everybody will say how much entered, how many, they won't give how much dropped out. So this is the dropout. Okay, up to elementary it is there. That is the danger for the country. We need to find solutions for it. I am not going to address everything there. I am posing this because some of you have to find solution. But it cannot be done purely by startup and this entrepreneurial mode. There has to be some public investment and make them economically relevant. Not now, the days are gone when you do only numerical. What is the learning? What is alpha and numeric is not enough. Literacy is very well passed. You have to have some small form of economically useful skill. And it will be continuously changing. Every 6-7 years it will change. Okay, next. So now, here I have already told, so I am not going to tell this, it is there and available. Science, technology and engineering, not told by me, a man who is both FRS, fellow of the Royal Society and also engineering, Paul Davis, Sir Davis, Chief Advisor to the Ministry of Defense, he spoke in INAE, Indian National Academy of Engineering. This is what it is. It will be good to recall this. For next, I will not tell detail of it. Science is search for better understanding of law of nature. From astronomy to this, despite massive step forward in each field, understanding is always incomplete. What marks a scientist is that he or she is never satisfied. The person who is satisfied, he is no longer ceases to be a scientist. You have to be convinced, oh, I don't know this. Even after that, all that solar thing what I said, oh God, it would throw open some 1 million scientific problems which is unsolved. Which is so if you see cell also, if you see something else. Even some of the economics problems, leaving aside only the regressions, you want, getting into the causality, you find something, then you will find 10 unknown. Actually, it is the ignorance of the most knowledgeable which progresses knowledge. Ignorance of the most knowledgeable. Unfortunately, our country is run by the knowledge of the most ignorant. This is a very big problem. Okay? This you have to understand. Next. Engineering is on the, about innovation, construction of new products and capability. However, a new innovation is invariably a compromise between many parameters. There is nothing called excellence or maximization of one good thing. Engineering is always a compromise. That is how the evolution is. Evolution is not for the best, not for the excellent, that which adapts. So you have to adapt to the market, you have to adapt to this, you have to adapt so many things. I won't get into this. You have got it, if you want, you can read. Next, about innovation, is in terms of engineering product, that is where it comes. There is a strong coupling between science, engineering and science, but this does not necessarily mean this engineering innovation directly from the latest improvements and understanding of science. You have to remember that. This is where we lost. We said, pump more money into basic research. You will automatically give product. It is not Coca-Cola. But you put it, and then so much of bottles come, or Haldiram. Nowadays, Haldiram also, you get this one, Chevda and all that thing. Next. Most obvious example is steam engine. I won't get into it. It's almost for so many other things I can tell you. Next. This is one thing very quickly I will go through. Now, globalization and all. That is where our bottlenecks are. Rich Indians have showed you. They are always there in the right side. They are already globalized. This was so even in the 80s. In 90s, even with all the severe import restrictions, they will buy, they will pay customs duty, otherwise they will smuggle through. So here, urban nuclei started getting metros and all. Here there is a reasonable interaction with the market forces. Now when it comes to low productive agriculture and all, we have one way for primary product, another one is knowledge skills are not there. This is the problem. For solution to the bottom fellows are in this, I will not get into all that, this thing, because some of them run away and come into three-tier cities and urban slums. That is what is subsidizing India. If they were not there, we will not be economically, globally competitive. It's very sad, a fellow who irons in your footpath, sitting somewhere, a hawker, they sustain the economy, but it's very bad. That need to be changed. Anyway, get on to it. Next. This I am skipping now. This is the status of Indian industry. Bottom one you see, we are still living on licensing and technology contract. That's all, bottom part. Our own, then technology development with my combination of technologies, little bit. Here, innovative idea upscaled into a market, but outside market and these are all right side, it's all businesses. We are very good. Reasonably good, but this to this, here totally breakthrough, almost zero. So this is our major fundamental weakness of the economy. Today, everybody talking about balance of payment and all that. Why our, this one, dollar going down by itself is not a problem. But we are having this continuously, you see, past 20 years. I think our economist friends may tell you, our this thing is, always we have more import and less exports. Why less exports? Volume is very high. It is only the primary products which are getting exported. Our own technology intensive products is not. Therefore, we will continuously have a current account deficit. I am not going to explain what that current account deficit is. That is what you do, what you purchase, and then you should be able to sell more. If you sell equal, in terms of, now it is in rupee terms, not in value terms, then there will be, current account deficit will be zero. So this is a major problem. the technology institutions in this country, and then the CSIR and all those, they are supposed to give this. Even this making very poor link. Next. Ideas to market, you would have heard all this. Ideas to market, innovation steps, CREE process, policy support system, outcome, intermediary outcome, out. We are policy support system, if you see, more or less they are there. How they work, another question. I'll show you the next one. Intermediary outcomes. Earlier we were not interested at all in outcomes. Now intermediate outcome, we are very happy. Then the final products and spread, we are very weak. Next. See, this will be a crowded style, couldn't help it, because this came in Global Innovation Index, edited by Soumitra Datta, chapter 7. This was, I was invited to write, and then I gave on the Indian innovation system. See, the processes, policy, procedures, knowledge inputs, finance, DST money, this one, HRD money, all that are there. Then the government funding bodies, DBT, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. From IITs, people won't know the problem. But most of the education institutions don't get at all. Now they have made a very funny rule saying that they won't give it to private institutions. So they are all, the boys and girls, they are all Indian boys and Indian girls. And takes money from the taxpayer, and then they are not paying. Even their parents would have been paying this thing, they don't give. But anyway, that's another story. Technology R&D centers, CSIR, ICER, you will find so many names. Certification standard also, there are lot of things have come. But intermediate outcomes are publication, patents, new designs, etc., startup, skill upgrade. But that is not enough. Are we doing, this is the last one. People, are we production of solutions, solutions, that is products or services that are affordable and accessible to, number one, people with a very low income. Advantage there is, even if you get some 10 paisa out of it, bulk is there, you get a profit. People in the middle class, I explained already. People in the aspiring upward mobile class, that is why one can make quick money. Fourth one is, people apply the products and services distributed to global markets. This is what we need to do. How many Indians product, India generated products which are there? You look at it yourself. You have to do a hardcore analysis. I have analyzed some of them there. Next. Next, next. So in India, this is a curve. Full cycle from new to market versus this. I owe to a friend of mine. He is Professor S. Chandrasekhar. He was in IIM, but he was in ISRO before. He has done for about 20 years of research and teaching in innovation and business cycles. Out of that, it has come. It also, my experiential knowledge, which I have gone through the whole process, both in ISRO as well as in the TIFAC, it shows the same thing. See, what we do is, most of the systems in our country, funded project and other things, we start with genetic defects. We give multiple goals, impossible goals. See, for example, LCA, why it is suffering? All the best in the world. It is not the way what we have made. So you have to do an incremental one. That is where you have to remember engineering is an assiduous process, what Professor Dhawan said. If ISRO has not done SLV-3 and then the subsequent these, which are all toys, if you see now, you will feel, oh God, you are involved with this. But if you had not done it and then gone into PSLE, probably they would have fallen flat. So instead, genetic defects, multiple goals. One for rural areas, one to be best in the world, has to be competing in American markets, no way. Then poor organization. We never tell very clearly who is a project manager and empower them. The reason you are Rao or Kalam or any one of them succeeded in ISRO, that is where I told about Professor Dhawan. Professor Dhawan and another one, great man, Dr. Brahm Prakash. How many know you? Nobody would have heard. Okay, okay, not bad. I'm happy. He, one of the great materials, all the nuclear power, so many things he did, but he did for us also. Midhani, everything he has put in. So they gave the protective one. That doesn't mean allow the fellow what you do. It's a very complex problem. That is why NASA succeeded. The whole American systems, poor organization. In spite of it, people work. So this is the classical S-curve, but on a day-to-day basis, it is not that smooth. It will be up and down. I don't have that. This one, I didn't want to put it. It goes in immediately you will find, I don't want to name that organization, every week they used to be telling that we have made the breakthrough, we have made this, we have made that, etc. Newspapers do it, nobody asks about it. Parliament questions also, they repeat the same. So then you see yearly euphoria. With that it is gone. Because DST projects are normally 3 years, SCRG project. The end of the 3 year before that you explain something, oh, we have done it, everybody is happy. So quick to close by founder, oh, very good, bandh kar do. Then when it goes into this up, that is where the real engineering starts. These are also engineering, but their engineering, this is a fragile period, or I called it as a Chandra, what is that called? Fragile part, Chandra fragility of, his name is Chandrasekhar, you call Chandra, of Indian innovation system. That's the bad. And it is not only mine, there are some other, one IIT professor, I forget his name, I have quoted him in that. He has done about Indian innovation system. It is this. So most of them fall out. So you don't have any Indian product at all in the market, barring very few. Very few. Some Amul may be there. We are talking about that Amul, which was 70 years ago. That's all. You don't have a software product to name. No security one. It makes me feel very bad when I say it. We were the first to do, or one of the first to do, TIFRAC, don't mistake it with TIFAC. TIFR, advanced computer or something, all valves. Advances in electronics industry, it comes in the national world publications. After that, what happened? What happened to ECIL? What happened to many things? It's empty. So this is the period. So now what happens is, now don't blame the industry. If somebody doesn't, if he goes here, then he picks up. This is partly to be by various other systems, venture capital variety of. So they purchase license from abroad, it will almost be a mature technology. Anything that is mature has to go down. If you are after 60, you have to be ready for which part of your body is going off. So that is what it is. So we get into obsolete. So many products are getting obsolete. That is what was the danger for many of our IT companies in the euphoria. They said, oh, we have got it. But they were working on this bottom end for somebody. He was innovating, he knocks it out. Afterwards, nobody will be. This you have to remember. So this part of it, you will have to get out. Next. We need to accept that all is not well with the output delivery of our vast and well-funded national laboratory system in terms of innovation and resultant products and services. For me, the last part is the only thing, innovation works. If it is not there, yes, happy you had this one, but you never won the race. You fell out of the race somewhere. Our industry is predominantly depending on imported technology, know-how and machinery, leading to severe import-export imbalance. This is there. Now, the result of this dollar going up, these fellows' import will become very difficult. As a net result, I am not worried that the import is going down. But there are many of their export products will not go because they are closely linked. Very high-tech products these fellows have to import, put it there and then send it out. So how to change, starting from S&T policies, the rest of the Indian innovation system. I won't get in every item. Next. Another very important thing is, you look for yourself. Any good thing you are told, especially those who are little elder, they will know. Anything good told in this country, it takes minimum 7 to 10 years. That is, I called it as an Indian, this is the one, administrative reforms in the Indian Council of, by publication that part is that, this is a very unfortunate truth. Anything, policy, things, very, everything takes late. This in the current world cannot be that. It has to be. In developed world, it is 1 year. China and all, it is 3 years. That is how they went fast. Because 10 years, everything has become obsolete. Then when it has become obsolete, we adopt that. So continual push through the intermediation funnel is very important. As we have done it in the early stages of that one, I will show. This is up to the point of initial commercialization and operation. Only that. You should not do after that. Then you should pick up. Things you don't succeed, don't give them oxygen or put life support system, they have to die. because economics is a very ruthless subject also. You know, let us die, gone. Something else will sprout. It comes from biology. To spread to all potential markets and systemic constraints, you need to remove. I can't address all of them. Next. This is the one which I do. This I owe to, this word itself, I owe to Professor N. S. Siddhartha. He was writing a book immediately after Vision 2020. He is here now. He was IEG and other thing. Very famous economist. I think they are friends too. So global business, technology, and knowledge sharing. So he wanted to show some of the TIFAC examples. So it's very tough to work with economists. I have learned myself many things. Not many things what they do, I don't do. Those of you who are technologists, you want to understand economics, read a book, Business Organization and Myths of Market Reality, Myths of Markets by William Lazzoni, MIT president. You read that. It gives a very tough one. It addresses the innovation and everything. I read other things also. So here, then when I explain to him, he'll bring him, Rajan, what happened, this one, can you do? All that thing is there in the part of the book. Then he said, oh, you people are doing technology intermediation. I say, I know you're doing it, but we didn't hear that. And that was the reality. So then I put it there. Then later I have made it into knowledge intermediation, because the one item is not only the product, it's got law, IPR, design, standards. So this one, because I had to give two dimensions, I put this. Actually, that sphere is, imagine it to be a phone. It's actually 3D. And 3D is not uniform. Some may be like this, some may be like that. So imagine that in your mind. So the problem is, anything we want to do in life, even if this, you want to say that I want to change the auditorium in some different form, I want to have a sound and everything. This one will be to start at T equal to zero, sitting there. This is roughly the product I want to be in. It may be an improvement in the product. It may be a cost reduction, anything. I want this, this may be 6 months, this may be 3 years, this may be 10 years, forget that. Now you start, you get at this one, there are a lot of technology uncertainties. No, I will stop it now. Sorry. I thought you wanted me to, this will be the last one. So, we start, there is a lot of technology. You always try it. It will be a very big problem. I don't know this, I don't know how this will, because when you are given a job to do, till that time you can give a lecture and then you sit a review, you can tell this, oh, why don't you do that, etc. But if you are put in, then jolly well deliver, I will give you money. Then you see all the technology and knowledge uncertainties. Then comes, business fellows look at some other thing. They look at business, market, I don't know who will buy this, whether this one, who are my competitors. There will be uncertainty for them. So life is uncertain. Everything in life is uncertain. Anything new you want to do is uncertain. Actually, really speaking, even the world is uncertain. But people don't know that the world is uncertain. I will tell you a frog, if you want to remember, I will tell you about a frog later. If you remember to ask it, it is so interesting. So everything is uncertain. So you are sitting there, suddenly it may collapse. Markets may collapse. But still we think it is certain. But here, everybody will bring all uncertainty. But what has happened in the Indian system is, just as I told science, everything they were doing, so these fellows also, oh, we know. They start working on reducing that uncertainty. They get a project, they get here, they get from HRD, they get from DRDO, they get, start doing the work. Then when they do this, when they are about to be coming near this, these persons are somewhere in a different world. Their uncertainties remain. So they won't handshake. So this fellow is zero. Similarly, there are also many situations, people don't talk about it. Unfortunately, many of our business management people have not done that study. All those things in those license permit quota Raj, technologies were imported by PSUs and many others. Fellows get this, they go and market, negotiate and all. They do it, actually when they get into a lot of technology problems, they will keep quiet. 30%, what I heard on informal estimate is, 30% of many of those imported ones are all out. Now they are slightly better. So what is to be done? Simply talking about it is good. That process is, you have to network them, all the possible actors, early in the game. Then technology forecasting, technology assessment, knowledge surveys, market surveys, business, make them to struggle. And here, expenses are not very high. Unfortunately, government won't support. Most government systems don't support. Even within your IIT, if you ask, they will not do. Tell me a project what you will do, how many papers you do, or how many patents you will generate. But this process is, thing will be very loose. You know, from SME, I want to do for the SME sector. So you have to understand, this is what we were doing in TIFA. It was a government funded one, we will do that. Then, by that time, these fellows act slowly, slowly, slowly. Both of them are simultaneously coming, or somewhat simultaneously coming towards the reduction of uncertainty. And that is where the projects had to be launched. Unfortunately, in India, many big projects and everything, here we don't invest time. NASA does it. They will have a phase. You see any project, there will be a phase zero, phase one, phase two. In ISRO, we adopted it quietly. We used to put a study project, study director. That fellow will go through all that. Remote sensing something, we will do all this. And then you do, and before you launch, we won't go for government. We could have easily got government fund. Professor Dhawan won't go in this. Wait, even 1 year struggle. Get all this, users, everything together. That is not done. So this part, this process is called technology intermediation. This is why I'm telling it is, many of you may not do actual products and services. This itself will be a very important thing for India. See, why make in India, they are struggling. Our industries are not, because I know it for person, because I know, I have been in CIA and I have been many things. Our industries are not, suppose a company XYZ, GE says, will you please do this? You call them for a review, we will all pontificate there. But you come, actually, can you do this product? Can you give the model for this particular thermal part of it here? Mostly they cannot do. So they are all struggling. You make an offset one. So when we state from TIFAC Vision 2020, 25 years ago, we said, take some of these, make them to do. Small initial support to help them by government. So this is one area in which you people can develop business models. You are not delivering, you are in the whole supply chain. This is the pre-supply chain, how do you enter in? This is one area you might like to think of. Next, I think it ends. This I am not going to tell now. With this, I am going to stop now. Now, you can, any questions that are there, etc.
So the audience can ask questions. Please restrict yourself to one question each.
Which one? You can wait. See, I want people to wait. Because you know what they say is something interesting has to be kept for the audience. Otherwise, everybody will go off. So, over, ho gaya. So, we wait for that.
Thank you for the interesting presentation, sir. Here.
Thank you.
Sir, my question is already we have that LCA project about that you mentioned. 40 years we could not develop our own aircraft development, and the technology transfer from France also now stopped. Where we are heading?
Where you are telling about LCA?
LCA.
Okay.
And,
okay, fine.
And when, again, if you have to start, we have to start from scratch. And also you have touched indirectly HAL also, Hindustan Aeronautics.
Okay.
But
I got it.
Yeah, please.
See, if you don't mind, I will take 2-3 questions together. That's the reason I'm writing.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks. So, it's always good to have a first this thing, but many often people don't do. But they think that asking a question may be what others will think. So, there is a Chinese quote for that. I will tell you later.
Good evening, sir. My question is specifically to the educational system, and from whatever you mentioned, how is it that the educational system lacks in trying to develop this kind of thinking that you mentioned in the end?
Okay. What is the lack in that? Okay.
I would ask a further question to this
LCA, okay. I say one A. Okay, excellent question. You actually embedded the answer also into the question. Okay, next. That's the reason I said that if I collect it, many of them will be common.
Sir, please don't forget to tell us about the uncertainty and the story of the frog.
Okay, frog, okay.
Sir, we are run by the knowledge of the ignorance. How long, from when?
Knowledge of the
ignorant people.
Knowledge of the most ignorant.
Yeah.
And then the ignorance of the most knowledgeable. You want me to explain it? Okay, I will do that.
From when?
Okay. Anything else? Then I will take this tranche first. And then I will go to the other one you can think of. Okay, now I will tell you. First I will take the... Still the frog I will do to the towards the end. Because it will... interrupt something, but it will be most interesting. That's a thing to take back. LCA, Einstein quote also, I won't leave it, because that I'll have to tell it. LCA and NAT, etc., you very good examples of how we fail. But you should not put only that one, only on the, all the problems are only on the LCA's head. You see the main battle tank. I think it is called Arjuna or whatever it is called. Every name it is given. But it precedes almost all the essays. Almost it started from the beginning of this one. Around 50s it started. You know, the world's best. You know, this is the problem with the Indians. In fact, the Germans used to tell me very nicely. See, Mr. Rajan, they say, for example, even a conference, you just say, oh, this one, we have a German project, laser in industry. 2 days, everything is put in. Everybody gives all suggestions. He used to tell, he was a fawn, this time I forget his name immediately. Very, very brilliant scientist also, he was a counselor. Say, you Indians, you know, we'll tell it very nicely. You have got an enormous capability to think of all that. But we Germans are very small. We can only think on a small item. So you just say, laser application in heavy industries. Or maybe then cutting and all that will come. So 3, 4, otherwise we can't handle. You fellows can think so many things. So this is how it happens in MBA. Everything was put in. Biggest one, this one, that one, fast mobility, etc., etc. It is around this. Why I am telling it, that has a lesson for it. Why, when we did it, we were all struggling. It has been not a battleground one it went. So many essays and others, they have struggled and then went under it. So it's still a problem. So some things government have pushed it to say something is there. It is not passing many tests in Rajasthan. 52 degrees it has to work. At the same time, Israel, the new formed country, they had a problem because for them they were surrounded by enemies all over. So they found they want a desert. This one MB, some M10 or something like that. I forget the name now. Of a Russian one. And Russians were proverbially beautiful in mechanical engineering and metallurgical engineering, etc. Proverbially, they were very poor in electronics part. For a variety of reasons. Because partly also is their philosophy with the communists around, but they had done a fantastic job. Bolshoi. Everything has to be big. In those days, even computers, we used to the Riaz computer, they will also put the weight of the computer. Total. So it's become big, so very good. So whereas IBM and all will put only the other capability. So electronics, they were poor. So these fellows thought, now let me tackle it. They bought a few. They worked on it. And improved the all electronics and avionics. Israel is the master in computer tanks today. We are buying, world is buying. Then they upgraded. It's not necessarily always reverse engineering, but partly it is also reverse engineering. No innovation can be there, innovation's history. No innovation can be there without imitation. It is there. But nowadays, it is all protected by IPR, so at least you do that imitation within yourself for some time. Otherwise, you can't go immediately. So that is the same problem with LCA. Oh, we will do with the fastest dip and this one, that one, etc., where we are not done engine. The Kaveri has flown, Kaveri has dried, but that Kaveri engine has not come. So it's a problem. I feel very sad. I told Dr. Kalam also when he took over. I told, why don't you give this, to remit the problem. There's 83, I know how it was formed, LCA. Dr. S.R. Valluri, very good man. But it is what it was. You know what I told Professor Dhawan once? Why, I've written it also in the, why it is aerospace in India, I would actually written now. It is there in the system. So why, in aeronautics, you see, look back, we have some of the best academics, world standards, were in India. Dhawan, Rajmahendra, Valluri, then later versions of R. Narasimha, so many are there, some Rao, so many are there. Then I told him, once we were talk, but in ISRO, you will not find any of those big names, Vasant Govarikar or this one. They have all done great jobs, but you will not find anywhere in the scientific paper publication. And I told him, we had such a relationship. I told him, sir, because he was so passionate to do something in India, some aircraft in India. Nothing came. But he worked on space, therefore he didn't put himself into it there. So I told him, sir, one of the reasons we didn't get aeronautics is you have got the best of the academics in that system, whereas ISRO has none. Because these fellows have to prove by doing product. So a Kalam has to do only product. He doesn't have one publication. You are at least different, but he was in science, but he has to do satellites. So that is what has happened for LCA. The same problem there with most of the system. That is why today, very unfortunately, you said NAT and all was not Indian one. It is everything which is done today, when we say indigenous production, which is around 20%, is all under license. That curve which I showed is all under license production. These fellows won't change anything. That was the nemesis of HAL. We have worked with HAL. I worked with, there was one Captain Prabala. I don't know whether he was a chairman. He was the executive director. At that time, we went to HMT. Aray Baba, you are the best in, though licensed technologies, you are the best machine tool fellows in the world, because they have imported variety of, India had the best of machine tools manufactured very low in those days. He said, electronics is coming, Baba. You give a machine, you don't give any money. Give machine, we will work. BEL will put, ISRO will work. They told no. Because they come under heavy industry. This comes under Ministry of Defense. We were space, but still Prabala was ready to put his neck out. It didn't. So this is the problem. I am a mechanical, so we are best. Whereas changes in those which is occurring, that is why the forecasting part, this they didn't do. Another thing is how much you can chew. That is why I showed that curve. You have to do it. That may be incremental. Take that and then go. So that is the answer for most of the other things, also, whether it is a power plant, atomic energy. We got stuck with the 250 megawatt. Koreans, I feel ashamed that our Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, have to go and literally beg with the Korean Prime Minister or President, please give us that after that 1, 2, 3. Please give us a plan. You know why? The current one you have to do is 1600 megawatt or 1850 megawatt, something on that order. The reason is the safety measures, waste management, all that have to be built in much more strongly than what it was before. Once you do this, you see, you don't have to know great cost economics. It is the MX plus C. That C becomes high. So you will cut off only in a higher one. If you do 250, you have to put all these things. So we are getting it from somewhere. Whereas some of the best scientists and others who have been in it, but they have not been focused. 250, Are Baba, don't be in 250. Go to 500. Go to productionization. So these are the... Almost everything. I don't blame any of these institutions. but very, very myopic. That myopia has come from megalomania. We know everything. That megalomania has given them the myopia. Unless we shed it, we cannot. Okay, now coming to education, what is the lack of it? What we have to do? I'll tell you something, I'll start with something, which is because I attended about 10 days ago. It's remarkable, I knew about it. This is on student satellites. Indian Technology Congress they had, and then they asked me to chair talk, etc. Then they had some good speakers. Our another, Milesami Annadurai was one, for Indian side. Then another one was an Israeli. Then a third one is an Indian, but he's working for a UK company. His boss could not come, he had come. So then, to cut a long story short, that Israeli guy, he presents so many things, even school children have done. Since it was asked, though I had to do a lot of homework. My friend R.M. Vasagam, who was also Vice Chancellor Anna University here, he's a great ISRO scientist. So he told me, Rajan, you there, I took it. Then some of these challenges I took because I learned. 9 satellites, student satellites have gone from India. You do research by yourself. Sad. None of them have been successful. IIT Bombay is there, IIT Kanpur is there, etc., etc. Touch kiya, ho gaya, satellite ho gaya. Everybody is. Then all the news items, it was so difficult to find out. Everybody says just launch, ISRO launches this one, that one, that college says we have done it. Then I dug through, not through the Google, because I knew somebody, because these things, unfortunately, people don't write. So the problem is, again, the same thing. You should have done by technology intermediation. Poor student, one year, you can't do that. Now I'm coming back to Israel. Not only Japan have done, Japan have reported also their failure. They are so meticulous. Their whole thing, some 100 satellites have gone in around the world. The survey, the one which went, recent thing which went into, launched by PSLV. Do you know that it is a survey, ordinary university, which has built over a period? They work with the Atrium, and then they made that. It's a very remarkable, innovative satellite. I am not getting into that detail. So this man, therefore, to celebrate Israel's, I think 23 or something like that, they are going 25 years. They are going to have 70 years, I think. 70 satellites, student satellites they are going to do. All of them will be successful or partially successful. This gentleman, when he was doing it, then he said, I am at the Hesselbania, something Israelia director. It is in the Tel Aviv University. He is the director of the satellite, all that. He is also a principal in a school. Full time, not just Jake Inspire Karo. He is a regular, this thing. This is what is required. The bottom from the school doesn't matter which language it is. Bottom from the school, you have to start. You know, suddenly when I told it in presence of 2-3 other professors, you should not teach those things. You have to teach fundamentals. They think that they only, other fellows don't do. You know what he does in the school? A satellite is broken down into the disaggregation, what I said. Thermodynamics of cooling. Battery technology. What are the sciences of electrolysis? Those students, even in the 8th standard, they will take only small. They do it. This is how. So our school system has to be, first of all, before orienting the school system, our colleges, IITs, IICs, etc. And at the same time, I respect blue sky research. Don't think that I'm all for engineering. But that blue sky research, everybody cannot be blue sky. Much of it, you need cloud in between. Otherwise, you won't get rain. So you have to have a small group, about 20% or so. Let it be. Don't ask them any questions. Let them do. But beyond that, you have to have a target-oriented. This is called directed research. Then, for the bottom of the SMEs, it will be some other thing. It will be consultancy. Hours we are not giving at all. A NISTAT survey shows that 85% of our SMEs do not get for any publicly funded organization. Somebody will do with one SME and go to one newspaper. That's not it. I don't go by that anecdote. I have a large number. It is not there because I know from actual experience. So that is what is to be done. You have to orient towards, I am not saying that you make them GE ready, this ready, etc. But you have to understand some of their issues. And orient the fellows right from the schooling stages. First, colleges, etc. have to change themselves. And that means your UGCs and AICTs, etc. have to go away. Either in the AICT systems and all, I'm there, but I'm telling you, I write it also. America, which doesn't have a UGC at all, it doesn't have a AICT at all, it regulates itself. They have got a multiple accrediting agency. Accreditation is important, but multiple, not one. Anything which is made singular, I am ready to say, it will become corrupt. Anything. If somebody says, in fact, I had told Jaswant Singh when we were writing some other report for IT, Nick. Seshagiri is a great fellow. He has done everything. Then I told Jaswant Singh, sir, I was trying to, 5 minutes, he wanted to go to TV show. The Prime Minister's task force tonight. I said, sir, please, I have greatest respect for Nick. Then Professor Indiration and all joined. You give me, I consider myself as a person of very high integrity. But you give me an authority for one signature, then I don't guarantee anything. My PA will do something. My pune will do something. My colleague will do something. It may even be they may go and corrupt my wife. I'm telling you, the systems are bad because it is mono, this thing. In fact, your IIT people or JE or people are trying to crack. IIT JE is very good, but just say that is not for ranking. Admission is left to the institutions. Just make that one rule, then the gate is open. Then you say that I will take above this. Some other fellow is saying, I am taking this band. So we have these excessive, then our courts, atrocious. In American system, North American system, I have talked to a number of them. VCPTU, I had a great advantage of talking to many of them. None of them interfere in academic processes. Any criminal activity which is normally under law, attacking this one, that one, etc. But marks, you see, high courts in Delhi says, show the marks. CBSE marks shall be shown. This admission shall be stayed. You people are relatively lucky. In affiliated universities, they all suffer. So many of these things have to be made non-judiciable. America has got 5,100 degree-giving institutions. There is no president of America will not do it. Department of Education will put information about the accreditation. Go and see it. In fact, I have studied it in detail for in Cornell University. So unless these radical changes, the control, the one of the worst control system two in India, one is agriculture, another is education. Therefore, the education sector is one of the most corrupt. Not that you fellows are, but not as individuals, but the system is corrupt. So this, if you regulate, market forces will take place. Many of these colleges which are closing down is not because of their quality or bad, because North India has started getting more colleges because the supply demand, still the engineering students are coming up. You allow foreign fellows to come in and put a campus here. Let them do. Let the academics regulate. IITs may take over a few those institutions. They may not keep the faculty, but they will tell them, bloody hell, you get trained this way. Do the following. Okay, I'll do. Okay, now, before any question, then I'm going to take the knowledge of the most ignorant, and then I will come to the frog. See, this idea came to me, I got it like this, but it is not my original. It comes from the Economist I read, The Economist. I keep reading it for almost like more than donkey's years, because almost 22 decades or more. Very interesting one. In facts and figures, they are excellent. Their opinion, They have to say what they say. You can derive what you want. So you imagine, take at the very origin of the human being coming. So he just sees star, sky, this, that, and all that. They have their own theory. They have a small this thing. Then slowly they start understanding more. So assume it to be a thick forest of circle. It can't be, need not be circle, but you draw a circle. Easy. Because all models require some good geometry. So make a circle. So these fellows are there. As their knowledge base keeps on increasing, they are clearing the trees. It keeps on. The circle of knowledge is going up. When the circle of knowledge is going up, you look beyond. Your periphery of ignorance also is going up. When you are here, the periphery of ignorance is very low because you got a small circle. You won't ask more questions. When you do, as that goes up, so as the knowledge keeps on increasing, the periphery of ignorance, and those who sit there, they are the front-end people, whether engineering, medicine, for this one, economics, social sciences, anything, they are there. Even philosophers, they will be there. So they look at, oh, this is untold, unsolved question. I have to solve, I have to solve. Many of them don't solve. They die also, but they transmit that. But whereas in India, unfortunately, in many countries it happens, but in India what happens is the fellows who are around, they have every solution. Now don't think I am telling only politicians. Politician, bureaucrat, there are many academics and others also, they do like this. Make them all one uniform syllabus, over. So they don't know the total system. So the knowledge of, whereas the humanity progresses with the ignorance of the most knowledgeable, in India we run most of these things with the knowledge of the most ignorant. Oh, he has solutions. If a person becomes minister, I have seen the academics, sometimes I feel so bad. Vice chancellors, directors of IITs and all go and genuflect. As they say, before they say bend, these fellows flat. This is there with most of the people. I'm not telling only about academics. Most of this thing, we respect the big power. So then that person starts thinking that he or she knows everything. I have seen additional secretaries in your HRD. I was also a chairman of the NIT, this thing. She won't even tell directors of vice chancellor to sit down. They go and see. Whereas I have been trained with Professor Dhawan. We will have any this one, professors, if I agree for I used to have so many things, parliament question. If you go for, accepted some meeting to talk for this thing, you'll say, Rajan, drop it, go there. So here, for us, we don't make a difference between a director and a professor. Same, they are knowledge workers. So that's what I'm saying. So this is what it is. Okay, now, frog. Then I will come to the Einstein quote. It's also somewhat linked. But please, don't do this experiment. It's actual science in it. I will ask a question also in the end. You take a big vessel, put a frog, normal room temperature water. Fellow will be very happy because it gets the water. So it's, put a small light, a small flame goes up. It is enjoying there because it is becoming warmer, 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 warmer. This fellow is adjusting, enjoying. Then when it becomes around 70 degrees, 60, 70 degrees, it cannot tolerate. So it will try to jump out, it cannot jump out. Whereas the same frog, if you put it in a 70 degree pot, in the beginning, it will immediately jump out. It will get out. Do you know why? No, the comfort zone, that is a general one. I want a scientific answer. Scientific answer, comfort zone is a nice word, good for cocktail parties or talking. What is it? Scientifically, what is happening there? It's biology. There are people who know biology here. Huh? Reflex action. There is also a reflex action. Why here that reflex action took place. Here it is not taking place. Please tell me. It didn't waste any energy. It was there, I say. Like that. So, you tell me. No, you come back. That is where the clue is. To make the body temperature, this is a cold-blooded animal, unlike us. We have a thermal control system. It won't happen with a human being. When he sees that this thing, because our thermal control system works, it is a cold-blooded animal. Snakes, this, that, and all. So it keeps on adjusting its body temperature to the external temperature. But there is a limit. So we are adjusting our system. So we think, SMEs think some tax concession will jayega, either academic this thing, some promotions will be available, some this one, what is assured promotion will be available, we can do some this thing, they will postpone it another 6 months, every field. So that is what it is. So that we should avoid. Don't be a frog. This is told, very nicely told, I didn't know it. Later I knew the science. He totally told Whittle, N. Whittle, you should tell that thing. Okay, now lastly, Einstein quote. Can somebody wants to venture to say what it is? Anybody? Just try, I say. So many things are attributed to, this also I don't know whether he actually wrote or not. But it is written there in several places, because I now found that many things attributed to many big people actually is not that. So many insert inside. But anyway, it is a very nice one. Einstein might have told it. I don't want to spend time in find out, but it's a very nice one. Tell me. Because that is the lesson which you have to take forward. Because all of you have inside you. Because many of us, I can now fade away. We can say that we wrote Vision 2020, this one, that one, etc. After some time, it will be in some Google thing. It will be lost. Because afterwards, it may not even be accessible, because we don't know what systems will come. But the fragility in the digital world, it will be gone. But you people, most of you have to live another, those who are around 25, you be ready for working up to 85. Because you live up to 100. They can't afford to have pensioners. Economists won't allow. They will say, make them to work. Today, economists take 15 to 60 as the productive age. Now most of that is breaking. So it is you have to shape the world. That is what it is. Okay, shall I tell you and finish it off? Huh? Anybody want to try? Try it. No, that is there. That is a very common one. Here we are talking about change. No. That is, I think you have made it one thing for Einstein. So you can also insert it somewhere, Einstein, it will go. Google, you can put it in. So but that one, knowledge is, imagination is more than knowledge, yes. It is attributed to him. That is not by him. He will never say such things. So here it is like this. Those people who continue to do the same thing again and again, and still expect different results, that is the highest level of insanity. I have never seen, as a word exactly, I'm not putting, I have never seen more insanity than the people who continue to do the same thing again and still expect different results. See, you are free to continue to do the same thing again and again. After all, Newtonian thing is, in the inertial frame, you continue to move unless forced by some other thing. But don't expect a change. If you want to make a change, it is not within the existing systems. You have to change them. The processes have to be changed if you want a change. Anyway, I hope that you get a strength by yourself. I hope God gives you the strength. Thank you again for that.
I now request HOD of Mechanical Engineering, Professor N. Ramesh Babu, to felicitate the speaker with a memento. I now request Dr. Rajan to sign our EML yearbook and add few words describing your experience. I wish to express a heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Rajan for his insightful lecture. Sir, it has been an honor to have you here today, and I'm sure that the audience has gathered a lot of knowledge and inspiration from your talk. Thank you.